Sean will show you. They're in a locked drawer. You have to have the cap, the hot lock. And if there's not enough in there, then
I'm gonna grab a couple for people.
Please, I have tons in my office. If there aren't enough in there, that's the stash that kind of goes away.
I brought a pen.
Even you.
No.
I so did not. I'm not even sure my phone is.
Look at this. What's this?
Sean,
how is this happening?
Sean did that for you. It's through our me.
Let's see. Take that with me everywhere
I go. Oh, interesting.
I'm
going to
have door prizes. Write your
awesome
name and email address down.
Okay, so Sean's cousin. It's not a problem, I think, telling you because you're never going to meet her and she's never going to meet you.
Huh? You are live, just so you know that.
Is it going right now?
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to mute it. We're unmuted.
Thanks for having us. Of course. Any excuse to get together, but I've been dying to this class anyway.
Hey, Andrew, are you going to something to write on? Or I just bought a little notepad, like at work, and I went to the car.
No. That is so awesome.
I
have clipboards I can bring in.
That'd be good. And I have several on my desk in that little thing. Are the boys upstairs getting jammies on?
I have these materials.
Okay.
If you want to grab them, I realized as I was getting ready for the class that I barely have enough of materials. So I'm going to have to order some of these books. I made these printouts myself.
Awesome. And I'll make sure, I'll give you this one back when we're done.
Yeah.
I have the big one that came with the kit.
Oh, good. So these ones you can keep.
Okay.
These ones, if you order a kit, you can go home with it. Just so you don't like it back.
Okay.
They cost money. So, do you want to just get started? Oh, it's only 7. Should we wait for 1 minute? show up? Who's another person?
I know. Oh, Elijah was supposed to go get my mom.
Okay. Hey, Elijah.
I can't tell you how often I say, go next door and tell Nanny and Poppy dinner's ready. And I'll call and say, did you not get the message? Dinner is ready. No, we're all just sitting here watching this TV together.
For you.
So your parents live next door?
They live right next door, and we have no fence between our two yards. So we just, there's actually a big rut in the yard.
It's fantastic.
We cannot keep grass in that rut.
Just go.
We love it. It works great.
Did you move to this house? You talked about it. They moved to that house.
They moved to that house because of it.
Oh my God. Mom and Dad, that was my sister's house until they died. Did.
Two, actually, I felt it wasn't awkward at all that it's like, oh, both of our neighbors are moving away at the same time. Is it us?
That's kind of weird.
Turn down the fence and you can come find out.
Exactly.
We have neighbors. That's awesome. My mom lives with us.
That's
which
cool.
Is really great, but it does, you know,
it's
we're a young couple and we might want to surprise you.
We lived with my parents for 4 or 5 years when he got, not four, well, 4 years when he got out of the military while we were finishing college, we went back. And it was good, and we were even looking at places to buy a big house with like two wings, you know, our wing and their wing. We were going to build a house somewhere. Then we just kind of got to the point where I was like, no, I think it would be better to have houses next to each other. That'll work. Houses near each other.
That's, yeah.
And we get to keep an eye on them. They're getting older. You know, mom's 68, dad's 63.
50 years, and now it's like,
go.
You know, her teeth are starting to fall out. My father-in-law, it's like, you know, Baker's cyst on his knee, and it's like a stress fracture on his foot, and it's a bad shoulder, and it's a bad elbow, and it's a bad wrist.
Like when the warranty runs out, it
yeah,
all
they're just,
out.
Yeah, so they're actually going to retire.
You enjoy.
Which I never thought they'd do, but they're not getting any younger, and
they're
like,
there.
They want to travel, and I want to do it before,
yeah,
and, you know, have that other surgery again, mm-hmm. You know, taking a long time to recover, so.
And they're sick more often than
there.
Yes.
Yes, honey. Do we have to go to bed right now, or is
yeah,
there
any... it's already.
Is there going to be any more people here?
No, I think that there are.
I'm
no
so
kids.
Sorry. I didn't bring my son because he wasn't feeling good.
I do kind of appreciate that. Thank
yeah.
You. We've been through enough of that.
Yeah. The good thing though, with the oils though, knock on wood, is that we don't spread around.
Yeah. Yes.
Like,
exactly.
Like, we still get sick, but we get better sooner.
And one.
And only
yeah.
One person gets
and
it. So don't spread that around
all. We've had that, and I swear it's every like Monday, Tuesday, because we pick it up at church.
Uh-huh.
And I know it's especially the two littles where they're like, here, here's the toy, you know, I'll blow. I'm like,
touching the doorknob, shaking the faces.
Here, you want that?
Yeah.
Totally. So, and then, but you're right, it's staying with the one carrier it's coming with, and then, but then. Like to
yeah, you should. But something different. Yeah. My mom got the flu this year. She was the only one in our house that got the flu shot. She got the flu. Now I vaccinate. Like I'm all pro vaccination. I don't know how y'all feel about that.
But I'm
just like I just don't do the flu shot because every time I get headaches for months. It feels like they injected directly into my bone. Like my whole
hurts.
It's terrible. So I asked my doctor a couple of years ago, is there an alternative to this? She gives me these homeopathic pellets. It's like $10 for a little vial like this. And it's enough to treat two people for the whole duration of flu season. And you take it like weekly, like once a week, for like 8 weeks or more. Anyway, my mom got the flu and she lives with us. And I got two kids at school and none of us got the flu shot. And she was the only one that got the flu. That was it. I mean, because I was using the feeds, I was spraying everything, oils, I was taking things internally. Yeah.
I figured if
anything
else,
you
know,
I'm
not over to this.
I'm not.
Yeah,
I don't, yeah.
I mean, like, cooking costs, you know, MMR, all that stuff, that's our kids are all, you know, like.
Well, that's funny.
I mean, no, don't need to start the questions.
But I think.
I love that age, because they get, they're eating all the time, but they're not moving in, and it's like.
And they just laugh.
The bummer, maybe, I'm just like, God. I almost, I, that was on my short, because I didn't know who was a boy or girl. Just telling, just like, it's not cool.
I figure I'm.
I'm Rachel.
I may not be able to see that, you know, that's not disrupting.
Janet?
Jana.
Jana, oh, that's my aunt's name, so that should be easy.
Jana, you look at this name.
It was a movie, so we should.
Okay. But you work on the Russ
one that's strong.
You taught at this elementary school down here.
So feel free. It's okay.
So yeah, you can like walk to work. Do you walk to work?
No.
But I could in theory.
If you're okay opening the door, then I'll open this door. But I'll still hang.
Yeah, totally okay.
Is that the first video sequence?
Yeah.
We have Bella in the line too, Don.
You don't like it, you can take that.
Don.
Do you want any spin jar chip dip or chocolate cookies?
Yeah, I was wondering what you were talking about.
Grab one of those chairs so I can still be on camera and still sit. Is that okay?
Well, I doubt.
Right.
You can take mine.
No.
It was a good job.
Okay, you have to chill out though, Don. Oh, you have two dogs!
One
is mom's. Okay! There's still two dogs in your house. Have a kid one with a plastic on it, if you want a regular one without the plastic.
Don, I don't want.
No?
No, but I'll have one cookie.
How's the cookie at the end?
Hey, you guys, if you want food for it, you can help.
We'll get around. Okay, boys, please go to bed.
Are you recording this, by the way? I have friends around the corner that don't live in town.
Yeah.
And I think it's one of those things that you can do, like you can.
Right, and it's not sure if I've set it up. Hold on.
Let's see. No. Margaret, I have just. Did you get one of these?
No.
I think I have just enough. If one more person comes, we're going to share.
Yes. Need to get her out.
Come here,
oh, okay. Oh, no. How did you get in here?
Oh, she fell with Daisy.
Oh, she needs to go out.
Come on, Bella.
Go in.
Outside, Bella. Outside, Bella.
Oh, Bella.
You want to get a dog, and I've been stalking the. Shelter's Facebook page every day. What kind of dog do you want? I don't really care. I want a dog.
You looking at
my ideal dog. My ideal dog would be one that like had a family and then the dog had to be surrendered because they moved out of state or something. And like, it's like a dog that like I don't have to work with. Like they're house trained, they're crate trained, they're, you know, they know kids, they know a family.
Mm-hmm.
And the shelter gets those kinds of dogs fairly frequently, mm-hmm. It seems like.
We have a dachshund that we just can't give enough attention to.
Mm-hmm.
So we were contemplating getting rid of her.
Uh-huh.
With a 2-year-old and
yeah,
a twin.
She's almost 10 though.
Oh yeah, so you know, I want a dog that's a little bit younger than that.
That's the problem. And we have to have kids to be on prescription dog food.
Yeah.
She has that back. So I'm like, I don't think you guys can take her.
It's too much time.
So I'm like,
for me. She's 10.
Sorry. I know. That's why I'm like, I'm going to find somebody that's willing to take that on.
Yeah.
Because otherwise I would not give her. Because I would feel guilty.
Yeah.
And her somebody that can't give her what I can give her.
Yeah.
So.
I saw there's a dog, there's a
Waller Cross
Senior Center on April 1st. They don't allow pets larger than 25 pounds.
It's a big, tubby lab that just, you know, like probably you've walked in the last 6 years.
You know, gray face and just, you know, sweet, but he's 10 years old.
Yeah.
I can't kids.
I know. I'm still getting attached to them.
Yeah. Oh, okay. She might need a bottle soon, so I've got one ready though.
Oh, that's
okay. If it's a hassle, don't worry about it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't think she needs it now. She might soon. So. I can give you her bottle.
She's happy just being held most of the time.
It's good. Because I don't know where I'm going.
I don't think we're expecting anyone else to go.
There was one more person that had RSVP'd and that's simply the address, and I don't know if she's coming or not.
So, okay. Did you have to let someone else know?
Hey, Emma.
Yeah,
I guess she's asking if she wanted to send me.
Yeah, usually. She'll start reviewing. You know, I try to teach at least one class a month. So,
for a little while.
But then, at the same time, people, like, when I first started teaching, people would be like, oh my god, it's my only chance. And now that I'm teaching more often, it seems like.
It's like, oh, we'll catch it. Exactly. We've seen several go by, and I'm like,
that's not
the best. Wait, now it's like, I'll put it in your pocket. Yeah.
How's it coming, Sean?
Yeah, I don't know if it's recording or not.
Yeah,
no, it's,
okay.
It's broadcasting. I know that.
It should go directly to
the YouTube channel. You already posted it for anyone that wants to go.
I keep turning this on so that I can ask. What's the name of that app?
Oh, it is, I think I just Googled essential oils reference guide. It's reference guide for essential oils. And this is a book, and I couldn't find my book, but it gave me a good opportunity to showcase the app. The book has been out of print recently, and I think it's because they're pushing the app. It was like $6.99, $8.99, something like that, and the book was like 12 or 15. So, and it's way easier to use than the book too. I love it.
One of the books.
Yeah, there's a lot of reference guides out there. So I don't know. I'll pass this around if you guys just want to play with it. You can look up oil. You can look up singles. You can look up blends. You can look up, you know, what's in the end. You can make notes in it. It's pretty cool. I really like it. So we'll get started. My name's Amber. I met everyone already. And I'll tell you a little bit about what got me started with essential oils, and then I'd like to hear from y'all kind of what you'd like to focus on. But I started my oily journey about a year ago. There was a woman that I met at a birth professionals fair. She sells essential oils, and I do massage. She's like, I want to come and teach a class, and I had just moved my massage office to some space and thought, you know, we've got space in the room, so let's have this class. So she came, and it was pretty well attended. There were about maybe 80 people there, and I was blown away by all the things that she knew in this like simple little, you know, starter kit that she was talking about. I initially started, so I bought a kit because, first of all, I was just amazed by what these oils could do for her and her family. She's got like three or four little ones as well, and they're always getting into messes and wiping their faces and spreading their germs around. And I've got two little ones. I also have a massage studio, so I thought it'd be a good fit for, you know, either home or work. Specifically, I ordered this kit because my two-year-old, Lulu, she has her own hashtag. Look it up on Instagram. There's all these pictures of Lulu up at midnight doing her thing. Her first word was go. So I decided I'd like to find an oil to see if we can chill her out. So I ordered this kit, and I tried the lavender, and I tried the peace and calming. Honestly, I'll be honest, I haven't found the magic potion that helps with Lulu, but in the process, I've discovered a million other ways I can help my family and help my clients. And I'll be talking about those different experiences throughout the class, so I won't kind of give you all my material now, but I really believe in the use of essential oils. I really believe in this product specifically, above other brands, and we'll talk about that in a little while too. And what I'm going to do today is we're going to talk about these 10 essential oils. I know there's 11 here. To make it easier for you, the Young Living, which is the company that I know the best. They just package it all for you, give you this starter kit with these 10 essential oils and this diffuser, and then a couple of sample bottles just to kind of get you started. There are classes, you know, essential oils 102, and there's, you know, classes specifically for pets, and classes specifically for allergies, and classes specifically for, you know, bathroom or athletes or whatever. So there's lots of different ways you can branch out into that, but if you don't know much about essential oils, this is kind of the way to introduce you guys. So that's how I started this. I totally believe in them. But I'd like to hear from y'all kind of what brought you here tonight and what is it that you'd like me to address or focus on during the class. So you want to start?
Sure. I just bought a kit right before I had my girls. A friend of mine told me a lot about essential oils, so now I'm just kind of wanting to figure out how to use them besides in the diffuser.
Right, right. So did you, so you haven't taken a class yet?
No, I haven't.
What made you buy the kit?
I'm all about all natural, mm-hmm. and I already use Melaleuca, mm-hmm. and I knew that essential oils worked, and I had gotten a flu while I was pregnant, mm-hmm. like the last 3 weeks of my pregnancy, so I didn't really have a lot I could use, so my friend mm-hmm. brought over some oils, and I used them on myself, and they seemed to help, and so I already believed in them, because I had heard so many things, so I just decided to buy the kit,
yeah.
so...
Okay. And so you also just diffuse them now?
Yeah, because I don't really, and I haven't had the opportunity or the money to buy the book yet.
Right.
So I'm happy to hear about the,
yeah,
because I'm really mad about them.
Yeah.
So
right. Yeah, well, during the class, you know, if you found something, an oil that works for you that you've been diffusing, you know, when we get to that, like, feel free at any point to input, because I know, Dom, like, you've had the kit for a couple of months now, too, mm-hmm. so you've had some experience here. So what brings you to the class?
Well, you know, I live here, so it's very convenient. I wanted to find out, like you, what to do besides diffusing, and I know I've looked up some stuff in my bag. I've been putting Valor on my feet at night to help with my snoring. And we've done some RC down the spine and some thieves down the spine
good.
For a couple of illnesses we've had.
Mm-hmm.
And other than that, just diffusing it is,
right.
is what we've been doing.
Right.
So, I know nothing.
Okay. So this is a good class for you to do. So everything's going to be interesting to you, right?
Absolutely.
Great. Good. And, you know, let me know when we get to an oil, too, if there's something, you know, you've heard of someone using that oil for other things.
Or, never.
You know, it's good for you.
Never. I know nothing
okay.
about oils and
okay.
nothing about anything.
Well, then stop me too if you need to go over something or if I'm going too fast or whatever. This is, you know, I've got all spring break. You're all weeds. How about you, Jim?
And mine's from noon. Sometimes I just have to say I don't know anything about it.
Yeah, you respond really well to that.
Yeah, I've been using the peppermint on my shoulder mm-hmm. and the lavender on the bottom of my feet at night to help wake up sleep.
Good. And does it?
I don't wake up as much.
Okay.
I'm waking up at 2:30 now instead of 1:30. So, you know.
It's good. It's a start.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a start. And there's other oils you can add too.
And I also want to find out about it for my grandson. Because
I'm sure
I'm going to be healthy enough to have some.
Sure. So as long as we're talking about sleep, and that's what got me on this kick. I made my own blend. I'm going off topic here, but I thought you'd be interested in this. I just got my sleeping time blend. I put it in an empty lavender bottle. One of these big bottles is about 250 drops, it's 15 milliliters, so I just put it like halfway. And I counted out about, I counted about 40 or 50 drops of this blend and then kind of about that much more of carry oil. And it's lavender, vetiver, cedarwood, and, give me a second, Roman chamomile. Put a roller out and glue this up on top of the water. If you want to.
I'd love to smell it.
Yeah, I'm going to pass all these around. And if you want to try any of these oils, like topically, you know, it's fine. Go for it. So, and that seems to work the best for her. It won't knock her out, but it does mellow her out enough that she's not bouncing off the walls. And I'll put it at the bottom of her feet, I'll put it across her head, I'll put it on her chest, wherever I can catch her. Apply it. So yeah, feel free to interject at any point with any questions or comments or anything.
And that's you too, Pat. She's on and she's asking me questions.
Oh, good, good.
She just said,
oh, what she, why?
Hi, Mom. Yeah, why are you here?
Why are you here? What do you want to learn? Just typing. And while she answers that, we'll start, what are essential oils? So essential oils are basically when you, you know, when you pick a flower, or break a stem or one piece of grass or whatever, there's kind of that liquid inside. That's the essence of the life of that plant. And so essential oils are that essence distilled down into these tiny little bottles that you see here. And I need to, every time I teach this class, I'm like, I can't remember what that number is. But it's something like rose oil is something like 100 pounds of rose petals distilled to one tiny little bottle. So the rose oil is the most expensive oil of all the other oils because roses are not cheap and it takes so much to create that one tiny little bottle. But the same can be said of all of these. You have a massive amount of peppermint leaves or lavender flowers or whatever it is that's distilled down into these tiny little bottles. So they're very concentrated, they're very effective, they're very potent. You don't really need a whole lot to address what it is that you're looking to address, especially with little kids. Little kids are really sensitive. Like when I do massage for, you know, 8, 10-year-olds, you know, parents are like, well, can we do a full hour? And I'm like, no, that's going to be way too much for them. We do like 20 minutes because kids react more quickly to things like that. So when I use it with my kids, I highly dilute these oils and maybe only use one drop on them when I would use maybe 3 or 4 on myself. They're highly, highly concentrated. And let me back up to, before we go any further, I forgot to mention this in my intro. I'm not going to claim that any of these oils can cure anything, or treat anything, or fix anything. The FDA doesn't like it when you say things like that, right? I can tell you kind of some of the chemical compounds of some of these oils, and I can give you some anecdotal evidence of how it's worked for myself, for my kids, and for my massage clients, but I'm not going to claim that you're never going to get sick. I'm not going to claim that it's going to, you know, cure your sciatica, but I can give some of my experiences. There are, and along with that, you know, there really isn't any, there's very little FDA oversight with essential oils. So it's very easy for a company to put, you know, 100% pure therapeutic grade oil on a bottle, and no one's going to come after them and say that that's not true. What I found teaching this class is early on, people who come to these classes to learn about essential oils, they find out how many ones are, and then they go out to the cupboard and they buy, you know, like a $7 bottle of lavender oil instead of the $20 bottle that Young Living has. They go home and they use it, and we get the same results because it really wasn't lavender oil. It was adulterated with all the other things. Young Living has what's called a seed to seal guarantee. So at the point that they plant that seed, point that plant is harvested, distilled, bottled in your hands, they oversee everything. So that they can absolutely guarantee their products, which is why they're the only brand that I trust to take, especially internally, because I know that there's no chemical fillers or anything. So what I'd like to do now is in the handout you have there, just to kind of drive this point home. That last page is two-sided. And it talks about adulterated oils and dangers. And I really just want to because it's really important, you know, when you're talking about essential oils, that you know what you're getting yourself into. I want you guys to be educated, you know, so you can keep your family safe. So I'm going to take maybe the first, I'll take the first 2 paragraphs. And then if we could just kind of go around the room, we're going to read this section up to the powerful influence of aromas. So adulterated oils and the dangers. Today, much of the lavender oil sold in America is a hybrid called lavandin, grown and distilled throughout the world. Lavandin is often heated to evaporate camphor, mixed with synthetic linalool acetate to improve the fragrance, and then sold as lavender oil. Most consumers don't know the difference and are happy to buy it for $7 to $10 for half an ounce in various stores and on the internet. This is one of the reasons why it is important to know about the integrity of the essential oil. Adulterated and mislabeled essential oils may present dangers for consumers.
One woman, I've heard the ability of lavender oil to heal burns. Use the so-called lavender oil purchased from a local health food store, which is filled with oil and water on her arm. But the pain intensified and the burn worsened, so she complained that lavender oil was worthless to pain burns. When her lavender oil was analyzed, it was found to be lavandin, a hybrid of lavender that is biologically different from pure lavandula angustifolia. Levels of fur, 7 to 8% that burn contrast has burn healing agents not found in lavender.
Jean Bonnet and Dee wrote about a similar instance in this book. Practice of aromatherapy. A man was being treated for a fistula, abnormal channel or opening in the skin of the anus by instillation of pure and natural drops of lavender estrogen. The patient had begun to recover when he went on a journey and experimentally left his essence home by a fresh supply of chemist. Unfortunately, this essence was neither natural nor pure. One single installation was followed by a painful inflammation of such severity that the unfortunate person was unable to sit down for more than 4 times.
In France, production of tree lavender oil dropped from 87 tons in 1967 to only 12 tons in 98. During the same period, the worldwide demand for lavender oil was on the east coast of the U.S. that specialize in creating synthetic chemicals that can mimic every common essential oil. For every kilogram of pure essential oil that is produced, an estimated 10 to 100 kilograms of synthetic oil are
I don't have my glasses, so I'm just going to have to try.
No, that's okay. You want to pass it on?
Yeah, please.
Adulterated oils that are mixed with synthetic extenders can be very detrimental, causing rashes, burns, and skin irritations. Common additives such as propylene glycol, DEP, or DOP, solvents that have no smell and increase the volume, can cause allergic reactions besides the effects.
Some people assume that because an essential oil is 100% pure, it will not burn their skin. This is not true. Some pure essential oils may cause skin irritation if applied and diluted. If oregano oil is at the skin of some people, it may cause severe redness. Citrus and spice oils like orange and cinnamon may also produce rashes. And conifer oils like pine may cause skin irritation on sensitive people. Many tourists in Egypt are eager to buy local essential oils, especially lotus oil. Vendors convince the tourists that the oils are 100% pure by touching a lighted match to the neck of the oil container to show that the oil is not diluted with alcohol or other petrochemical solvents. However, this test provides no reliable indicator of purity. Many synthetic compounds that are not flammable can be added to an essential oil, including propylene glycol. Furthermore, some natural essential oils high in terpenes can be flammable.
Some researchers feel that because of their complexity, essential oils do not disturb the body's natural balance or homeostasis. If one constituent exerts too strong an effect, another constituent may block or counteract it. However, synthetic chemicals like pharmaceuticals usually have only one action and may disrupt the body's homeostasis and cause various adverse side effects. So that's from what a lot of people call the EOPR, the essential oil pocket reference. It's not distributed by Young Living. This is an outside source that that white packet is based off of that I put together. It does have Young Living blends in here. It does have singles in here as well, and it has information about the chemical compounds and oils and the adulterated oils too, and kind of the risks that come from that. So thanks for bearing with me, because I think that's a really important point to make. So moving on to how to use essential oils, and I'm wondering, hey, Sean, I forgot to set one thing up. I'm wondering, can I open up this? I'm sorry, you guys. I'll get my computer unlocked. I was hoping, I need your, you could put something up for me on my computer.
Don, can you get four? Actually, I'm on the
Dana. Oh, gosh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, wait a bit. I got
okay.
Stuff
I'm sorry.
I just wondering if I can get on the internet because this is going to come up later in the class. Thank you. So how to use essential oils. There's a couple different ways. You can aromatically, you can diffuse them. The starter kit that I ordered when I first got started with all of this came with, like I said, these 10 essential oils, and it comes with this diffuser. I love this diffuser because it has this reservoir in it. I add, depending on what oil I'm using, I'll add like 4 to 8 drops of oil. I usually start off with less because it's easier to add more than this to take away, right? And it has a couple different functions. So this one's continuous. I put 8 drops of Thebes oil in here right now. This one's continuously for about 3 or 4 hours. You push the button again, and it'll do little bursts at like 30-second intervals. So it's kind of nice when I want, like tonight, my family's dealing with allergies. So I'm going to be putting lavender in there. And I'll put it on this continuous burst. It also has a function where you can keep it on either continuous or these bursts, and then push this button, and it'll turn off the night light function, which is kind of nice.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
You drive
with
my husband.
Yes. Uh-huh.
And I had accidentally turned it on the burst through the day, and I was like, there's something wrong with that thing.
No.
Turn on, turn off, turn on, turn off.
Is the burst?
Wrong with
yes, the burst.
Well, that's what I keep mine on, is the burst, so that it lasts longer.
Uh-huh. It's nice. Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah, if I've got, like, so I've got, you know, my son is dealing with strep and hand pneumonia. Right now.
Oh, it was strep again?
Yeah. And hand foot mouth. So he's got like swollen tonsils and blisters and screaming at him. Correct. So I've had it going continuous Thebes in all of them. And I'll move the diffuser around every time the reservoir runs out. Yeah, like I said, tonight I'll be doing, thank you. Tonight I'll be doing lavender oil running continuously. And yeah, I don't like the nightlight function for myself, so I am. So I'll turn that off. My kids obviously like it, so maybe she's not. So you can, aromatically, you can put a drop in your palm of your hand and hold it up, over your face. I'm wearing my diffuser necklace. Got this thing. It's got like a special clay in the back. And you just put one drop of whatever it is you need. And you never wash it off. And I've never gotten it's never gotten like muddled with any of the previous oils. So I wanted to wear that to show it to you. I'm wearing a drop of clarity tonight to help me be able to be more clear in my articulating myself. So aromatically is one way. Topically is another really common way. So so you can apply it directly to sore muscles. I do that a lot for my clients. Soma Valor is really good for spinal alignment. It's not one of the ones in the kit, but you bought the kit before I think they moved it around. So
I had to buy Valor.
Oh, you did?
Myself,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So it's really good for spinal alignment, sacral alignment. And I just apply it, right down the spine. Thebes and oregano together is a really good immune-boosting, germ-fighting combination. And I'll apply that to the bottoms of my feet, the bottom of my kids' feet. I'll do a drop of purification when I travel on an airplane because they're so gross. I'll do a drop of purification on a Q-tip and swab the inside of my nose so that any of that recycled air first has to pass through my purification oil. So that's, and it works. So you can apply it topically, like directly to the area, massaging on the skin, the bottom of the feet. There should be something in this book too. I think there's maybe some Vitaflex points. Perhaps some reflexology points on where to kind of massage some of these oils. I mean, some
other
maybe it's not. Never mind. Just kidding. Oh, yeah, here it is. So, and you've probably heard this too, that there's every organ system in the body has a corresponding point on the foot for reflexology. So, sinus, you know, some sinus pressure. I'll do like a drop of eucalyptus or a drop of peppermint with the carrot oil, and I'll massage it right here, and that's the sinus point. Really helps. Topically is another one, and then internally, you can take these oils internally. I would not recommend taking any essential oil internally because of the information that we just read. I really trust the Young Living brand. I do take these oils internally. You can't take jasmine or neroli oil internally or any of the blends that have those oils in them.
because they're distilled a different way. I think they have to use a chemical to distill those other ones. All these other ones are steam distilled, so they're, it's just the essence of the plant. I do take these oils internally. With my son being sick, I've been doing a drop of oregano and a drop of lemon oil and a little shot glass, and I drink that. It tastes terrible, and I got sick. So, in fact, oregano oil is another one that isn't in this kit, but it has a very high antioxidant value. So they measure, it's called like a BORAC value, I don't know what BORAC stands for, but like a couple of blueberries, and it's supposed to be very high antioxidant food, has an BORAC value of 2,500. And oregano has an ORAC value of 15,000. So I put a drop of that in, and it really just, anything that I'm going with, it's kicked out.
Now, what's the difference between putting something in a capsule with a carrier oil or just drinking it?
You can put it in a capsule. It just seems like a lot of work for me to kind of measure it all out.
I know, that's what I was thinking.
Yeah, but if you want to take a high dose of something, because oregano oil tastes terrible and burns going down, I can only do one drop at a time. And then I don't want to take any more after that.
So I guess that does help if you don't like the flavor or the taste.
Right, yeah. So I'm putting that carrier oil in, it's just going to make it easier on your body because they're really strong. They're really strong oils. And you can buy like those little gelatin capsules online.
I actually saw them at the new health food store up on University.
Yeah, I'm
sure. Got a whole bag of.
I'm sure Burns carries all that kind of stuff to make your little capsules of it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've even had a car diffuser from Natural Grocers. It's you plug it into your cigarette lighter, and it has like these little gauze pieces, and you put your oil in there and stick it in there. It heats it up, and road trip, it's great. So there's lots of different ways. Oh, and then also, as I said before, got started. We were talking about other apply these oils topically. I've heard of people making. Suppositories where you take your carrier oil, your essential oil, do it, mix it all up, put it in a like a smoothie, fill it up, put it in the freezer, and then you just cut off what you need and insert it. So especially if you're dealing with hemorrhoids or like digestive issues, if you're super nauseous and you can't keep anything down, that's another effective way. I haven't used them that way, but it seems like it would work one with it. So now moving on to the really fun stuff. Talking about actual oils. So, and if you have any experience with these oils, too, please feel free to check out. First one I'm going to talk about is lavender. And if you can only afford three oils in your medicine cabinet, I would recommend lavender, peppermint, and thieves, because the three of those can basically do whatever.
What was the third one?
Thieves. That's what we're diffusing now, and we'll get to this one. So lavender,
let me put over there.
Lavender can do it all, and feel free to apply these oils yourself if you want to. You can do it all. It bug bites, burns, rashes, eczema. Obviously, it helps for relaxation. Sometimes it can be, with kids with ADHD especially, sometimes it can actually be more stimulating than calming, because lavender can also really increase your concentration and your focus. So it's really good if you need to study for something and stay calm and stay focused, but I've heard that some children with ADHD can have the opposite effect, so keep that in mind. It's really good. I've used it recently on a road trip. We went out to Colorado and my 2-year-old got and is that the second child, because the first one would be like, oh my god, pull over, but the second one I was like, really, can you wait 5 minutes, try not to touch yourself, we'll be at the next house. So we, my husband, stepped on it, we went 90 miles an hour, and made it to a gas station, and she just kind of sitting in the back, so we get her all cleaned up. She just got car sick, it was wearing her jammies, and the car was hot, and we're going through the canyon, and so I got out my lavender oil, and I put a drop behind each one of her ears. Little travel case, which oil I want to travel with. So I had a drop. I got out my lavender oil right here. I put a drop behind her ear to help with the play with that. Yeah, I love it. And then also, I had my purification oil, I had lavender purification spray bottle, so I just like sprayed down the air the smell. But it was really good, so it really helped with her car sickness. Night and yesterday for allergies. Lavender is really good for allergies. I was at a friend's wedding in November, and it was an outdoor wedding on a farm, and there was a big rainstorm. I don't know if you remember this big rainstorm on Thanksgiving. And it was an outdoor farm wedding. So we're all stuck in this barn. It's pouring down rain, and I knew it was going to be that way, so I brought my lavender oil with me. And I had a friend, the one who was going to the lake, she couldn't come. She decided to duck out of this class, but her son, her 10-year-old son, started breaking out hives, right? Because it was like a damp barn with mold and the goats that had been in there the week prior, and started breaking out hives. And of course, we're in the middle of nowhere. She doesn't have any bathroom with her. So I got out my essential oil, and I'm like, this might work. She's like, okay. So I gave it to him, and he applied a drop to his wrist, he applied a drop behind his ears, and the hives, started disappearing within minutes. And we just kind of kept doing that, like every half an hour, just kind of giving them, I just hand them the bottle, like, you need to leave it up to you. And if she was able to party the night when she got home, ended up giving the dose of Benadryl anyway before I went to bed. But it helped, really helped. That same night, I have two diffusers. We've got three bedrooms and two diffusers. So I put one diffuser with lavender in the one room, one diffuser with lavender in the other kids around, and we went about it. Both of my kids woke up the next morning, fully fine. And Lulu, my little one, she's got a lot of respiratory problems. I was really surprised that she woke up the next day. She's not wheezing, her eyes were not watering at all. My husband and I didn't get it, and he woke up just nervous. The next week, he was trying to move it through the system. It's really, really good for allergies, especially this time of year. It's really helpful. And I have a couple different peppermints I want to show you. I've got my peppermint. I have peppermint with a roller cap. I've got it diluted 50-50 because it's really tingles the skin. It's really good for fevers. And I'll put it on the back of my kid's neck or behind their ears or on my wrist, whatever, to help with the fever. And it burns them and then it pisses them off and that's what they say. So I'm like, well, just put a roller cap on it and do it, and then I'm not like struggling to find my carrier oil and my peppermint at the same time. So I really wanted to drive that point home, that thing that we read in the back of your folders about the peppermint. And I have or acacia peppermint that I bought that I covered. So smell this one first, and then smell this one. See if you can tell the difference. Figure oil do you use? It depends. At Sarma, my massage business, I will use apricot oil or like my massage lotion. When I'm using on moisturizer, all I drop with something, or just my moisturizer, I drop with something. With my kids, I use coconut oil. That's what But I recommend using the high quality oil because these molecules are so easily absorbable by the body. It's a huge difference, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Yeah. These molecules are so easily absorbed by the body that they'll bring in whatever the carrier is. So it's important to have, organic if possible, definitely plant based. So, like, I wouldn't mix this back with your bottle of blue oil, because a lot of it has like mineral oil in it and your body can't metabolize that. So I usually use coconut oil. So what do you guys think between the differences? Try it, and peppermint's cheap because everywhere. Why would you?
She's constantly fighting it over her garden.
Yeah, see? Why?
Rip it out.
Why? But it's just one of those things. I think this is $4 or $5, right? And I don't know how much peppermint is actually in here, so you probably have to use more than just a drop or two of this. This involves by itself is like $21.50. So. Anyway, so peppermint is fantastic. It is, it's not for breastfeeding mothers.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
I tried to put it.
Okay. it can drop your milk supply.
And somebody told me that, which I didn't know with my son.
Yeah.
I actually did use it with the peppermint, and that helped so much. I didn't have any problems.
Really? That's awesome. Great.
Is it hard to increase milk?
No, it decreases milk supply.
No, is there an oil that will increase?
Oh, probably. I could. There's an app for that. Okay. You want to look it up? yeah, I would say like fennel would probably be one.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Fenugreek.
Yeah.
I tried everything to get mine.
Yeah.
To increase.
Well, peppermint oil would not help you. So, in fact, I never knew this, like, but apparently my exterminator knew this. We use an all-natural exterminator, and he comes by my house, and he makes my house smell like peppermint schnapps, and it's great. And it gets rid of all, like, the weevils and the carpenter ants and the spiders and everything. Well, I've been seeing him. He's been our guy since before I got pregnant with Lulu. So then when I was pregnant, he started spraying with clove. And then when I had Lulu, he continued to spray with clove. And I had asked him why he switched it, and he said, well, peppermint oil supposedly, you know, drops your milk supply. I was like, I wouldn't know, but you know that. She was 25 months. And he came at breastfeeding. He assumed that I wasn't anymore. But I kind of wanted to run that experiment myself because I had ample milk supply and it wasn't, you know, she was able to eat solid food by then. Anyway, and he sprayed with peppermint oil, sure enough. That's so peppermint oil is not for breastfeeding mothers. It's also not good for kids under 2 years old. There's different schools of thought on this, but there's a 1 in 10,000 chance, according to some of the literature I've read, that it can actually exacerbate breathing problems for real little ones. I have used peppermint oil on Lulu. She does have respiratory issues. I have used peppermint oil on her in the past when she was maybe a year and a half, but I had also already had a lot of good success in using oils with her, and I felt that I was just using my mother's intuition. And I felt that she had any problems, but for the ones that are a little bit able.
Applying to their skin, can you still diffuse it?
Probably not.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because that's interesting, because I used to diffuse peppermint one night with the girls, and they had the most restless night. Like, that was the worst night. We had marks like, do not diffuse peppermint.
Never.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Well, I don't know if it was just like stimulating, because it is very stimulating to
yeah.
breathe that. But that for some kids that are already dealing with respiratory stress, you know, if they've got a cough or the croup or something.
Okay.
And you think peppermint, oh, that's going to clear them out. Sometimes, in rare circumstances, it can actually make it worse.
Okay.
From the literature I've read. So I just used my mother's intuition with that. I didn't want to pass that on to you. And that RC blend does have peppermint oil in it. It's like the last ingredient. So I've used that successfully with Lulu when she was real little, both topically and diffusing. I don't give my kids any of these oils internally. I think they're too little. But again, you use your mother's judgment with that, and maybe, you know, as NG gets older, well, I might start using something like that. So I did have a gargle the other day and some salt water because of his dealing with his throat. He screamed at me, but you know, so whatever, get over it. So peppermint oil is really good. It's very uplifting. I use it for fevers for my kids. Like I said, I use that little roller bottle so I put back their neck, their temples. It's really good for indigestion, stomach bugs. I've had a lot of good success when all the other kids at MG school were puking. And he comes home and he's got a tummy ache, and I put swipe the peppermint on the bottom of his feet or add a drop of Lotus Navel, and he has a tummy ache, but he doesn't puke like the rest of his friends. It also humerus, tummy ache, indigestion. I use it a lot with my clients in soma. I find that peppermint oil is really good for like tight fascia. So it's like the connective tissue that surrounds your muscles. Muscles that are tight, it's the casing around it that gets, you know, this is just a lot of connective tissue through here. So I'll use a couple drops of peppermint through their forearms. With our IT bands, really good for connective tissue if you're dealing with like tendonitis. Oh, and I also have a really nice mouthwash that I add peppermint oil to as well. It's not as harsh, and so it tastes nothing. Lemon oil. This is a great oil. This one has a lot of really good antibacterial, antifungal, antimicrobial properties. But like this is like $11 and it's $250. It's just so clean. And the starter kit actually, you can see I've got bottles of various sizes. The starter kit comes with all these little 5 milliliter bottles, but I've had this kit now for a year, so I've had some in that time. And most of the oils that they sell at Young Living, most of the starter kit ones come only in the larger size. So that's why we have the larger ones here. Lemon is really great for fighting germs. I add it to like a squirt bottle. I'll add like maybe 3 tablespoons of Dr. Bronner's Castile soap, maybe 8 to 10 drops of tea tree, thieves, lemon, something like that, something that's going to kill the germs, and then top it off with distilled water. This one is tea tree. I'm trying to draw this one tonight, actually. But I just made lemon soap before I came. I'll diffuse it to help, all those particles will go all over the air and kind of help kill any germs that are on the surface. I'm spraying things with Lysol and these chemicals. I'll diffuse lemon oil. You can use it for skincare, so you can apply it neat to like pimples or warts. I've got a friend who's got a couple little boys and they're always getting their hands and everything. It's warts all over their hands and arms. Toes and everything, and she'll just apply lemon oil on that, just a drop of lemon oil, you know, a couple times a day for a couple of days, and it's not because it's got antiviral properties to it. I also take it, I primarily use lemon oil internally. I'll add a couple of drops to a glass of water, and it helps to detoxify the liver. If you do take any of these oils internally, don't do it in a plastic cup, because they'll leach, they're so powerful, they'll leach some of the plastic chemicals off. So I always use a glass when I'm drinking this. Let's see if I forget anything. Oh, you can add it to an Epsom salt bath to help detox pull more toxins out of the muscles. Really massage. You know, we tell our clients all the time, you know, drink water help detox and cleanse. You add a lemon oil. Yeah. Oh, and then you can also, I've heard people making vegetables that fit stuff that you buy at the store. You can make like a fruit vegetable spray and clean your apples and grapes and stuff with lemon. Frankincense. I love this oil, and I think it's so wonderful that they give it to you in this kit. It's not a cheap oil. This one has a lot of really fantastic immune-boosting properties. It's frankincense oil is high in sesquiterpenes, and sesquiterpenes are not a chemist, but they're
beeswax.
Yeah, I guess it kind of does a little bit. Yeah,
like natural beeswax.
Yeah, sesquiterpenes are this molecule that are like supercharged with oxygen, and they're very very small. So it's really easy for them to be absorbed by any tissue organ in the body. Because the sesquiterpenes are so supercharged with oxygen, they really help to repair damaged DNA. There's been a lot of research done about frankincense oil and cancer. I don't know a whole lot about that, but I've heard those kind of frontier cancer. Again, I'm not saying like it's going to cure you, but that have these sesquiterpenes and these good DNA repairing properties. So I use it for immune boosting. I have what I call a flu balm, and it's a little sticky because the label just came off of it. But it was an empty frankincense bottle. If you want to swipe it, you're welcome to. It's a blend of a bunch of different oils, most of the ones that are in here, and a carrier oil. But I use that when my kids are sick. I just swipe them with this immune-boosting flu balm to really to boost their immunity. I primarily use frankincense oil for skincare because it is supposed to slow aging, help soften wrinkles, sunspots, stretch marks, And I'll put a drop of frankincense oil in my moisturizer almost every day. And just after I put it on, it's like my skin just glows. I mean, I wish I was able to go home and wash my face a couple times a day and just like reapply that. Because I really can see a big difference when I use that. So that's usually what I use it for. But some people do take it internally. There's a flu balm capsule recipe for those little gelatin capsules. You can apply it topically with a swiper. People also diffuse it for meditation. It's one of the biblical oils, so it's very helpful for meditation and centering and uplifting at the same time. Melaleuca alternifolia, also called tea tree. This one I use for both skincare and for germ fighting. So that's what I made this hand soap out of. I added some tea tree oil to it. I just added 8 drops to it. I'll alternate painting between using the frankincense and the tea tree oil, kind of depending on how my skin looks that day. It's really clarifying. People believe that they'll add it to, like, I've been adding it to my toothpaste. Lately, I'll just add a drop of my toothpaste on, and I'm going to water and put a drop of tea tree oil on it because there's a child in my house with strep right now, and I just want to cover all my bases, right? You can add it to, you can make your own homemade mouthwash. I've heard people have had some success avoiding lice with tea tree oil. I think once you get lice, you just have to treat it with a blowtorch. I've not knocked on wood, I haven't had lice in my house, but like, once you get it, you can't get rid of it. But I've heard that when lice is kind of making the rounds, people will add a couple drops of tea tree oil to their kids' bath or to their shampoo. And apparently, it's supposed to help for that as well.
Okay, I have something to share.
Yeah,
that's something again. I didn't know my husband saw me without sharing because he skanked your brainworm, and I thought it was dry patches. This is when we were purpose person. I went to the dermatologist, and they put me on 1 medicine. 4 weeks of being really sick and it burned my skin, that I feel. And my aunt was in the oils several years ago in the 90s. And she said put tea tree oil on it and it was gone almost immediately.
Really? I believe it. Yeah,
because it's so sick.
It has this antifungal properties, right? And that's what ringworm is. So that makes a lot of sense. Yeah. Some people have used it as a blend of, there's a blend called Melrose, and one of the ingredients in that blend is tea tree oil. It's supposed to be good for rashes and fungal things and eczema and stuff. So that makes sense. Any questions so far? We're like cruising through this. Okay. The next one, stress away. I have, so when you order the kit, they give you one, I think they might give you 2 now, roller packs. So when I got my original kit,
I got one.
Yeah, it's you know, welcome. Step one, maybe it did,
it just looks like they gave you a spare lid.
Yeah.
But then if you look like inside the lid,
yeah, because you put, so you pop your dropper thing off, you put the roller cap on, and then when you twist this on, it fastens the lid on for you.
Huh.
So this one, stress away, there's people, so a lot of my clients will, they have these diffusers that plug into the USB port of your computer. So I have clients that order this bottle of stress away for me, and then they'll diffuse it at work. Because their coworkers are idiots and they're driving them crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, you can diffuse other things too: lavender, peppermint, thieves, lemons.
Awesome.
I love this one. So I carry this one. You can see it's well loved. It's kind of all dirty in the back, so I keep it in my purse all the time. I go to a lot of really important, like high city official meetings, and I have to be both grounded and calm, and also focused. These meetings last a long time, and it can be aggravating at times, and there's a lot on the line, so I have to stay, focused. So I keep my stress away with me before I go to these meetings. I swipe it. It's a blend of copaiba, lime, cedarwood, vanilla, acacia, and lavender. So copaiba is an anti-inflammatory. That's going to be good because if your body's stressed out, there's going to be inflammation as well. Lime and vanilla are good because they're really uplifting. Cedarwood is a great oil. I used it in that Sleepy Time blend for Lulu. Cedarwood stimulates the pineal gland, and the pineal gland produces melatonin. So it's really good for diffusing at nighttime to help sleep. Apply topically, once your kids get a little bit older. And it's one of the ingredients in here. Lavender, as I said, is both uplifting and helps you focus, and also really relaxing. I admit I don't know much about acacia. I could probably look it up on that app, but that's another ingredient in the stress away. So I'll use it for myself. I'll just apply topically. There is no carrier oil in this one. I just swipe it directly on because I'm a grown-up and I can do that. I would do that for my kids. And for my clients, I'll usually use it coming up to work and I'll freak out. They don't have a neck anymore, and I'll put a couple drops in my palm, and I'll put my massage oil, and I'll just hold it over their face when they're face up, and I'll massage on the neck till they walk out, and they're still smelling that the rest of the day. I'm going to be right well for your diffuser like this, too. Purification. This one, I don't really like the smell of this one, but it's medicine, right? I use it for a lot of things.
So I can diffuse it once.
Gross. Oh. Yeah. I don't like it. So that
smells like this.
But it works really good. It's got citronella in it. That's why it smells kind of funky. But it's really good for a bug spray. I make a homemade bug spray of purification, lavender, and peppermint. So I'll put like a little, what I'll do is I'll put like a little bit of sea salt in the bottle, like a quarter teaspoon of sea salt. I'll add the oils to it, maybe like 5 drops of each, and shake it up so the salt absorbs the oil. And then I'll top it off with water because the water dilutes the salt, and then the oils are more evenly distributed.
Is it distilled water?
Yeah, ideally, but yeah, I mean, I just fill that thing up with tap water. It's okay. It's okay. Yeah. Distilled water is better.
But. For the bug spray, because I'm always looking for something natural. Does it help with like mosquitoes?
Yeah.
Big time, because.
Well, so, even when you use that DEET stuff, they're still going to get through.
Yeah.
This is all natural. I really trust it. And then it also has the added effect of when the bugs do get through, it really helps to heal the bug bites. Mm-hmm. Because the purification oil pulls out a lot of those toxins. And then the lavender oil soothes the skin, right? And then if you add peppermint to it too, it's a little bit kind of stimulating, healing. It kind of like, I don't want to say numbs the pain, but like distracts your mind.
Sorry, we're digging the little face in the window.
Who's So I think it does help. It's definitely better than nothing.
So purification, lavender, and peppermint?
That's how I use it. Yeah. I use maybe 5 to 6, 7 drops of each. And then a little bit of salt, shake that up, and then top it off with distilled water. And then when they do, inevitably, it does help, but they're gonna get through because bugs are gonna eat through anything, even if you're wearing, a burqa and spraying yourself with like pesticide, they're still going to get through. It helps with the sting afterwards. I am relatively new to Texas. I've been here 6 years. Apparently, there's these things called chiggers.
Oh, yeah.
Right? So, I got chigger bites this past summer. First time. They're terrible, and they bite you in the places that you're not supposed to scratch.
Yes. Like if you're wearing shorts and you sit on something and they get you right along the short line where you're...
Right in the... It's terrible.
Yeah.
Purification oil, really good for the chiggers. I will tell you though, speaking from experience, these oils are very concentrated and very powerful. So I had like 20 chigger bites, right? Because they just...
Yeah, I know.
And I'm like, okay, purification oil, that's good for bug bites. Drop. And about 20 minutes later, I was like,
whoa.
I mean, it was pulling out all the toxins. And I was loopy the rest of the day. I'm not going to overdose on this stuff in the same way that you would overdose on, like an over-the-counter medication. But I learned my lesson. Dilute the purification oil. So now, if I've got bug bites, I'll you know, I'll quit. I got a couple fire ant bites. I was on the story the other day. My legs swelled up. I'm like, I've never had that reaction.
They're bad.
Yeah. So I put like 3 drops of purification of carrier oil and massage that whole area instead of doing, you know, drops directly on there. It was like the same amount, but somehow having it diluted made it easier for my body to absorb. And I would certainly not do 20 drops of purification oil on myself ever again. I learned the lesson. You can diffuse it. It's not my most favorite smelling oil, but it really is effective for cigarette smoke. My mom's a smoker. She smokes outside the house, but it still comes in on her clothes and her hair, and after a while, it starts to smell. And I'll just hand her the bottle of purification and the diffuser, and I'll tell her to clean her room. And she lets it run, and it's better. It's so much better. I don't smell the ball anymore. My son has really stinky feet and likes to not wear socks. Right? So you put a drop of purification oil on a cotton ball, slide it in his shoe overnight, and it's, I mean, because you can wash their shoes, but they still kind of smell like,
oh, yeah.
Yeah. So purification oil really helps for that. It really helped when we puked on her car seat and we were, you know, in the panhandle on our way to Colorado. I just got my bug spray because it was lavender oil and purification oil, and I just, you know, wiped up her car seat, sprayed that down, and because you don't want to ride the next, you know, 600 miles and car that smells like vomit, so that really helped as well. And like I said, I traveled to Louisiana in January, right at like the peak of flu season, and I've got this trip, and I'm like, I'm gonna be in an airport. I went to this conference that's shaking all people's hands, and I'm like, I'm gonna get sick. I just know it. So I packed my oils, and every night I put several drops of thieves and oregano on the bottoms of my feet, in between my toes, just got everywhere. I every time I apply my lotion, like after the shower, I put the oregano or thieves or whatever, just to have an effect. And then I also, when I was at the airport, not even only at the airport, but just periodically for this trip, I would put, like I said, a drop of purification oil on a Q-tip and just swab it inside of my nose, so anything I was breathing had to pass through my lung. And I went on this trip for, I think it was like 3 days, in and out of airports, shaking hands, all the people I've never met, I don't even know, during the height of flu season, and I came back and I didn't get sick. So I've got to think there's something to all of that.
Do you guys have resistance to these or not?
A resistance to the oils? Mm-hmm.
Are you just using so many that you know?
You know, I don't know. I mean, I think, I don't know. I use them every day now. And it's just kind of part of my daily routine. I would say probably starting off to maybe, so when I first started and I heard that you could use lemon oil to cleanse the liver, I added a drop to my water. I had a glass of water. And then I'm like, I want to do it again. I had it again. And I did that a couple times throughout the day, and I got a stomach ache. And I don't think it was because of the lemon oil itself. I think it was because my body was detoxing. It was pulling out a lot of stuff. Like when you get a really good massage and you don't drink enough water, you feel kind of woozy. You know, that was kind of my experience with these oils. I would get kind of headaches. I was like, am I allergic to this? What is going on? And it wasn't that, as my body was detoxing.
We get that with plexus too.
Yeah, yeah.
It's
so
your body's detoxing if you're not.
When you get it out of your system, you can take these oils and you can maybe take more of them, and it's not going to make you feel ill in the same. And it's not that the oils are making you feel ill, it's the detoxer.
Your body letting go of the nasty stuff.
Absolutely. I find I'm drinking a lot more water than I ever did before too. My body needs it now because I'm constantly detoxing with it. Frankincense or the tea tree every day on my face with the, you know, the taking the thieves and the oregano internally to not get sick with the, you know, just diffusing things. I'm constantly using my oils. So I'm drinking a lot more water, I think, and my body just wants to be constantly drinking. So does that answer your question? Yeah, so that's a good question. Okay, so moving on to Panaray. This I think is still the original bottle that came with my kit like a year ago. I don't really use this one a lot at home. I use it a lot at work though. Panaway is a blend of 4 different oils: helichrysum, wintergreen, clove, and peppermint. Helichrysum, and this is, I'm glad that they give you this bottle in the kit too, because that tiny little bottle that you bought it by yourself at wholesale is like $32 or something.
My favorite to diffuse.
It's really, you diffuse it?
I do.
Do you?
I like it.
Wow. I like the smell of the wintergreen in it. And it has that child safety cap on it too, because wintergreen's not good for kids.
So can you diffuse it for
our kids? Our kids have never had a problem.
Okay.
In fact, it's one of the ones that two of the three boys like, but I have one that doesn't like mint, so he'll come down and be like,
oh, you're doing mint. I like this one. I don't use this one as much at home because I find any aches and pains from, you know, my family, I can usually address with peppermint or lavender. And it is kind of a more expensive oil, but I use it a lot at work. It has, especially for people with arthritis, joint pain. I've got a client who's working on rehabbing back and shoulder. And there's only so much you can do with this, right? I can't get in there. I've had some clients who have knee surgery. I can't get underneath the kneecap, and there's a lot going on in the kneecap. But I'll add a drop or two of Panaway, and I'll usually honestly dilute it with a couple drops of peppermint as well, just because it is a more expensive oil. I see so many clients at Soma. And then my carrier oil and massage it. And then this body absorbs that. We've got circulation going from the massage surrounding the joint. And it really helps them heal, gives them a little more mobility, really just feels good. Helichrysum is a very, very expensive oil. A little bottle of helichrysum is like $80. And I do have a bottle of helichrysum that I bought with my points, because there's no way I was going to spend $80 on a little bottle. But it's really good for trauma. So deep cuts, it really helps heal. There's pictures you can find on the internet of people that, gashed themselves and, like, didn't want to go to the emergency room or couldn't afford to go to the emergency room. And they'll add helichrysum oil, and you can see the pictures of before and after, even 24 hours, how much amazingly better it looks. So helichrysum is really good for trauma, really addressing damaged tissues. The clove, the peppermint, and the wintergreen are basically all kind of numbing. It numbs the pain. So it's a really fantastic oil. Like I said, I don't use it very much at home, but at work all the time. Plantar fasciitis, arthritis, people recovering from knee surgery, arthritis, panicles. Fees is probably the most popular oil. Whenever I place an essential oils order, I'm always happy to go that one to order with Thebes.
Yeah.
Thebes is a combination of five different oils. It's clove, lemon, rosemary, eucalyptus, and cinnamon. The legend behind the name of Thebes is that back in the Middle Ages, when the Black Plague was ravaging Europe, there was some spice traders that got stuck in this village that was quarantined because people were, dropping dead of the plague.
She is so cute.
Thank you.
How old is she?
Almost 3 months.
She'll be 3 months on the 30th.
Yeah.
I've lost track of the weeks.
When you have two, you're just like, 2.5 months?
I don't know. She's less than six and more than birth.
Yeah. Something like that.
So these spice traders got stuck in this village and looking for something to do would rob the homes and bodies of the dead and dying. Eventually they were caught, and this being the Middle Ages, they were certainly going to be put to death. But the villagers made a deal with them. We'll let you live if you tell us, what it is that is keeping you from not getting sick. And it was a blend of these different herbs that they would rub all over their bodies several times a day to help prevent illness. Each one of these oils has their own germ fighting, immune boosting, antimicrobial, antibacterial properties. So you put all of them together in a bottle, and then you're like supercharged. I wanted to show you. There's this really cool picture that I've seen. I want to show all y'all. Someone did an experiment where they were growing staph in a petri dish.
I saw that.
Yeah, it's really cool.
So you can see they have these four quadrants, and they put on a piece of gauze, leaves, hand sanitizer, peppermint, and lavender. And they're growing staff in this petri dish. And you can see with the lavender and the peppermint, there's a border around there. So the staff is growing, but it's not touching the gauze itself. Can I hold it up to the camera? Can you see this? Well, maybe you just have to send me the link.
Yeah.
Okay. So that it's not touching the lavender or the peppermint at all. With the hand sanitizer, it's just blowing right over that, right? And with the thieves, there's not any staff growing in that border at all. So the idea is that, you know, you've heard of these super bugs, you know, we have these same chemical compounds that we're using all the time in our antibacterial hand soap and our bleach and our Lysol. It's always the same chemical compound. And it's gonna kill a lot of those germs, right?
I'm sorry, stop.
It's gonna kill a lot of those germs, but the germs that it doesn't kill are gonna be these super bugs that just kind of continue to grow and gross us out and make us sick. But at the same time that these germs are evolving, these plants are evolving. Season to season, region to region, year after year, these plants are constantly evolving to make themselves as strong as they can be. A plant can't just get up and move if there's a threat. It has to be tough if it's going to fight off drought or bugs or, you know, pesticides or whatever. A plant's going to be really tough. So it's going to be constantly evolving as well. And so the theory is that, you know, the reason these oils are so helpful with, you know, fighting germs is because they're coming from plants. These plants are growing and evolving at the same time that these germs are also evolving. So it's a constant battle between two of them. The oils seem to be the more effective choice in a lot of cases. So I use thieves for everything all the time. I always have a backup bottle of thieves because you don't run out of thieves. Oh my God, what if you did? I got sick. So I diffuse it. I put a drop in my coffee in the morning, especially now I'm running for city council, and there's a lot of stress involved in that, and I cannot be sick ever. So I put a drop of thieves in my coffee. It took some getting used to. It had a weird flavor to it because of clove and eucalyptus. It's kind of weird, but I'm used to it now. I like it. It is an ingredient in this flu balm thing. This one is an ingredient in here. You can, like I said, take internally, you can add a topical. I've been gargling with it because my son's got strep and I don't want to get that. So I've been gargling with that or tea tree oil or lemon oil. I'll just kind of switch all that. I'll take, like, when we travel, I'll take my diffuser and my oils, and we'll go to a hotel, and hotels are close. And so I'll set the diffuser up, and I'll put the thieves oil in it, and turn it on, and we'll go get cool. And we come back, and it's that the thieves is kind of, you know, dispersed across this little room, and hopefully kill any of the germs of, you know, cleaning the mindedness. And I have 100 more uses for thieves. You can add it to a spray bottle to kill germs when you're cleaning your kitchen. You're welcome. You can make one of these little, like these little glass bottles here. That's usually one of the door prizes that I have. You can make like a little feed spray for like shopping cart handles, or tables at restaurants, because I see all day from the table at restaurants. That is gross. We've got kids, their food is always on the plate. I also make a hand sanitizer out of these, and you're welcome to try some if you like. It's obviously it's thieves. Aloe vera, distilled water, and vitamin E oil. So it's not going to dry your skin. It's going to be more effective than hand sanitizer, as we saw. Smells good, and a little bit goes a long ways too. That is actually one of the other door prizes. This one, the little bottle of hand sanitizer. Use hand sanitizer. So yeah, so take this with you. There are 101 uses for thieves. Growing staff in a petri dish is just one of many more. And then the last one is joy. This one smells good, right? Yeah. I really, really like this oil. This one does have jasmine in it, so I would not recommend taking it internally. It's really uplifting. Sometimes when I have a really busy day ahead of me and I just don't know how I'm going to get through it, I use the Joy. It's a combination of rose, bergamot, mandarin, ylang ylang, lemon, geranium, jasmine, palmarosa, Roman chamomile, and rosewood. So you can see it has, thank you. So you can see with the ylang ylang and the chamomile, it's really grounding and relaxing, and you can see the bergamot, the mandarin, the lemon, it's gonna be really uplifting. It's really good for mood stabilizing. Two uses that I primarily use this for was, now I have a bottle of geranium, just straight up geranium, but before I bought that bottle, I used it for my period because I get really bad cramps and bloating and just terrible. And geranium is really good for balancing female hormones and helping, especially during your time of the month. And so I just have a bottle of geranium that I use. But before I bought the geranium, I had the starter kit, so I used the Joy. And I would just apply that with, you know, like maybe 3 or 4 drops, depending on how bad it comes, maybe sometimes more, with coconut oil, and I just massage it all over my abdomen and my back. Now, like I said, I just use geranium oil straight up, but you know, I have a bottle of Joy at Soma, and sometimes people come in and they're like, oh, my period just started, so I'm like, there's oil for that, let me help you out. The other use that we primarily use it for, and this is, I think, still the same model from my starter kit, so I, you know, it's taken us a while to get through it, but my mom has bipolar. She's always had bipolar. They always thought it was depression for the longest time until I could figure out, you know, finally when she was a little, she's like, no, I really need some help with this. So she has bipolar. She's been medicated for, gosh, I don't know, almost 20 years. But you still, even with your medication, you're going to cycle through. You're going to have your highs and your lows. My mom, when she gets low, that's where she stays. That's why people thought it was depression for the longest time, because she wouldn't stay manic for very long. She would just, like, wallow down there. And she takes her medication, but she still will cycle through. So when she gets low, you know, I grew up with this, I saw this, she lives with us. We both, like, let's just call out that element of mom, like, needs help right now. And I would give her the bottle of the Joy and the diffuser and just go to your room. What normally would take her, even with her medication, gosh, a week? Without her medication, I don't even remember how long it would take her to come out of this one. With her medication, it would take her maybe a week or so, I think, before she could kind of start coming out again. She'd have more energy. She'd come out with things really. With the Joy, it's a couple of days, maybe. I mean, she'll just diffuse it. She'll lay down for a nap. She'll diffuse the Joy. And within, for sure, 48 hours, she's herself again. So it's really uplifting, really mood stabilizing. It's a really effective oil for that. I'm not sure, honestly, what other people use Joy for, other than it just smells really good. Like, my kids, sometimes when they're just, like, drive each other crazy, I'll just use that one. Maybe just because it makes me happier? I don't know, but...
It actually says apply the root on children to lift occasional moodiness or defiance.
There you go! This one. There you go.
Boys!
There you go! It's a good one. So that's the starter kit. That's like the 10 essential oils that you would get that, you know, Young Living starts you off with. So you kind of know. You got your mood stabilizers. You got something to help you sleep. You got something to help you concentrate. You got something to help with your low back pain. Something to help you with plantar fasciitis. You got something to kill germs. You got something to treat your sunspots and your warts. You know. So they kind of cover all the bases. Then just for fun, they throw in this little bottle of Citrus Fresh. It's orange, tangerine, lemon, mandarin. Experiment. Some people clean with it, some people diffuse it because it's really uplifting. I drink it because I really like the taste of it. I'll add a drop or two to my water, especially if I've got like a long planning zone meeting. It's just a nice treat, honestly, and it just kind of helps keep me a little more focused. So the kit is just the smaller, like 5 milliliter bottles. A lot of these are refills,
And I do diffuse the citrus all the time.
Yeah.
And especially in the morning, it's very invigorating.
Oh, yeah, I bet it would be. Yeah.
Very like, okay, let's all wake up and get going.
Yeah.
And
yeah. Keep moving.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a good one. So I just keep it like next to my tea. And I'll just add a drop to my tea or a drop to my water. I'll make up like my
use, I don't know if you've seen, like, maybe quart jars, my mason jars of water, and I'll add a couple drops of coconut cream and it makes the water just a little bit cloudy.
No, it's water.
It's water.
Really?
Essential oils. So.
Yeah, vodka's an essential oil.
Right? Okay. Essential is something, anyway. So that was a lot of information in a short amount of time. Do you have any questions?
This was actually perfect. The fact that I've had the kit for several months, gone through a little bit of my own research, diffused a bunch of stuff, and it's like, oh, now I'm ready to actually take in the information.
Yes, now
that's
I get
perfect.
It. Yes, yes. See, I took this class, and then I got the kit, and I kind of knew a little bit about it. But I had to go to another class, and I was like, oh yeah, that's right, I remember you said that. And, you know, just, I get a lot of practice being a massage therapist. Let's see what this oil does. You know, report back to me how you feel. You know, with my kids. So it's and sometimes you have to go to more than one class or, you know, do some background work and research yourself if you feel like you're getting it. I mean, I've been doing this for almost a year, and there's still a lot more that I need to learn. Do you have any questions? We went through this stuff really fast. Yeah? Let's do some real friends. With that, let's go. Let's do, how about since there's four people and I have a hostess gift for y'all?
Hmm.
I'll give you the gift. And then, so I draw your name. The first one. It's God. Yeah. So I'm God in here, and I have a little pocket guy.
Oh, very cool.
I have a squirt bottle.
Oh, awesome.
And then I have a little spray ball and a little, those two little blue bottles there.
Oh,
yeah, so you can
make more things. I was actually sitting here thinking, I wonder where I'm getting those.
There you go.
Okay.
Thank you. So, this one. So you win. I guess we don't have something for everyone. My, I thought I had three prizes. I'm sorry. You get either the hand soap or the hand sanitizer. This is tea tree and this is these. Okay.
There you go.
Sweet. Okay. Okay, so I apologize. This isn't something for everyone. I just lied.
And you gotta watch out for her. She's not even in politics yet, and it's already started.
What? And Rachel. So you get the hand soap. Yeah? So this is just 3 tablespoons of Dr. Bronner's, and then about 8 drops of tea tree, and then just filled up with distilled water. And you can use that all over that. So. And you can really use, I mean, any essential oil you want, but just because. There's a lot of drugs in my house right now, just
something
that's too true. Yeah. Can you
do
this
as a hand sanitizer?
Yeah, that's the thing that we just passed from the good one. Yes. Yeah, it doesn't smell good. And also, now everyone wants that recipe, so I'll make sure to send that recipe out. So, yeah. So, I think we got everything. I'm sorry, I don't have a prize for you.
Margaret? I'm sorry?
I'm sorry, I don't have a prize for you.
Oh, that's okay. She lives next door, it's okay.
Okay, good.
I'm always like,
So with that, if anyone, now you already have a kid.
Yes.
You already have a kid.
Mm-hmm.
So if anyone else wanted to order a kid, I guess, Jenny, if you wanted to sign you up by me and Margaret, if you wanted to order a kit, sign up another Dawn's job. But if you wanted to order a kit for what it's worth, and there is no like 2 drink minimum at these classes, like I just really want people to have this. But just so you know, if you did want to ever order a kit, it's $150 plus tax and shipping, and it comes with this diffuser, the 10 oils in small sizes, and a couple of extra samples. It's like a juice blend called Nature Med. Which, have you tried that, Dawn? Have you tried the Nature? Because I know you guys do plexus.
I haven't
either. I mean, I took the oils internally. I shouldn't use right up this juice, but it's just kind of
yeah.
Other people love it. They just do like little shots, and it's supposed to really boost their energy.
We still have it with our plexus.
Yeah. So, little things of Nature Red, and then like little samples and stuff too. I think there's a picture of that.
And then when you get, so when you do get the kit, then too, you can always order oils at wholesale price anytime you want. But if you want to just, you know, order from me, if there's something that you found in the class, if you, the next time you just order, just let me know. Because I order something like once a month. Do you have your own wholesale membership too? You order your kits? How much did you pay?
I went to a friend. I ordered under her.
Yeah, and you have your own wholesale membership, okay. So you have your own.
Yeah, because it is cheaper than what it says.
Yeah, because it's the retail.
I have to sign in.
Yeah, that's right. So you have a wholesale membership.
Okay.
Yeah. So, and we can talk too. I wanted to talk to you guys about kind of because I know you're familiar with the plexus, kind of the business side of all of that.
Yeah.
And I wanted to. Here sooner to talk to you about that, but if you have a few minutes afterwards, I'll talk to you because I know you have a membership and want to know like how to work with that. So, so that concludes tonight's class.
Thank you so much.
Yeah,
thank you for having it.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you very much.
Pardon the constant mess, but you know, dogs, kids, this is about as good as it gets.
No, it's great. I can see your floor, that's better than my house.
We have a saying in our house where, you know, if you want to come visit anytime, standing open door policy, come see us anytime. If you want to see the house, make an appointment. It's going to be right.
Yeah.
If someone starts selling the oils under you, do you get credit for that?
I do.
Because my daughter's wanting to stay at home alone with me.
Yeah, I do. So she wanted to sign up to start this. I'd be happy to sit down with her and talk with her or call me about it. So, basically, whenever someone signs up for a kit, we get a commission check from that. Mm-hmm. And then for the first 3 months that they order, we get 25% of their order. And then after that, I think it drops off to like 8% or something like that. But then if they sign up, people underneath them, you continue to make some profit. I think two generations. I think if that second person signs them up, that would be your own. But there are business opportunities. I mean, I'm not going to lie. Like, I teach a class like once a month, maybe twice a month, and I sell a couple of kits, and I get, and I, you know, it, like anything, the more time and energy you put into it, the better the return. I don't put a lot of time and energy into it because I have a whole lot of other things going on, but I still get a commission check every month that's consistently $100. And I don't put a lot of time and money into it, honestly, because I don't have time for that, but it helps. I mean, that's, you know, that's 2 weeks worth of groceries.
So they're not like
that helps.
Yeah.
So
she didn't mind me asking that.
No, it's fine. It's something that I don't usually talk about in the classes because I don't want people to think that I'm like I want to be the Avon lady. But it is. I mean, there's, you know, there's benefits to it. Comes to be made, absolutely. So.
And yeah, that peppermint oil. I hope y'all don't mind me asking.
Oh no, please. That's the whole point. Is.
In the morning, because my shoulder, my shoulder hurts so bad in the morning. I get up, I take it. I didn't have to dilute it, and I just put it on straight.
You can.
And then when I put my makeup on after I get out of the shower, I'm feeling like I feel real weird.
Uh-huh.
I didn't know, is it because it's so strong? Or?
It could. Yeah, you could just be having. I mean, how much are you putting on?
A bunch.
So there you go. You don't need a bunch.
Okay.
You don't. I mean, it's really concentrated. With cheaper stuff, there's 85% peppermint oil in that. You're going to need a lot more to get the same effect. So, I mean, when you come in for your, can I share this?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So when you come in for your massages and, you know, something's bothering you, when I use the peppermint oil on you, for your shoulder, I might use 2 drops. 2.
Oh.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Okay.
And so the bottle's going to last a long time. I might use 2 drops with the carrier, with the lotion, and I'll massage directly on there. But it's so strong, and it burns, it tingles, and it probably feels good, but it's too much of that is maybe not as helpful as it could be.
Okay.
You don't need that much, so yeah. That might be why you're feeling kind of lucid too, because it's just really detoxifying and healing a little bit much. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Daisy May.
Maybe 3 drops would probably be okay. I mean, it's a whole big area.
Well, I'm going to wait to order something and see what.
Sure.
What
that's fine. Out. Yeah, let me know at any point, you know, if you or your daughter want to sign up for a kit and you know how to come in, because because you can do. So I order my oils like once a month, and I just place the orders probably a year tomorrow or the next day. So I'm not going to order again until April. I'm probably not going to teach a class in April because city council, that's going to be May 9th. Election day is May 9th. Make sure you register to vote. I'm just going to be busy next month. I'm probably not teaching classes, but I'm still going to place an order. Whenever you or your daughter want to sign up for a kit, you can do that at any time because you don't have to wait for me to place an order. You just sign up, you get a kit of your own, and you have a wholesale membership that you can either use just to buy your own oils, like for cheap, or that you can, you know, try to make a side business out of. I mean, you're not, and she's never obligated to, like, you don't have to sell anything.
Yes,
Yeah, and I love, what I love being a massage therapist and doing this too, because all the oils that I have at my house are, like, because I keep ordering, like I have like these huge orders, and then Young Living's like, thank you, here's more free things for you.
Well, and it should be a tax deduction too because of your...
It's a tax, it is a tax deduction, yeah. So I'll buy oils for Soma, and then like my friends will, like I think you've ordered oils for me before too, and I'll order for my friends and just charge them wholesale tax, and I'll pay for shipping for all the orders for Soma anyway. But then I'll get like your points, you know, then I, after everyone like, places their order and everything comes in, then I go back online and I see how many points I got, and then I just like buy all the free things that I want for my family, for my personal use. So there are, there's ways that you can work the system, but you're certainly not obligated to buy it if you don't have to.
And is there a oil for weight loss?
Yeah, probably. I think they have like a whole like sleek line.
Mm-hmm. Where is that?
I haven't tried it, but
where
it
is
it? Was up there a second ago.
Yes.
I know.
Oh, good.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks for coming over. I hope you learned something.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Hi, Pat.
Is she watching?
Yeah, she was.
She was?
They have this whole, like, sleep line.
Yes,
it's supposed to help balance blood sugar and, like, yes.
Night, darling. I love you too. I'll see you tomorrow.
Though, you
want
to talk about weight loss, you're talking about these guys. Oh, I'm just going
to hang up here.
Yeah, please. Yeah.
So I inadvertently promoted just 5 minutes ago. I thought I was sending myself notes. Lavender purification, peppermint for bug spray, frankincense on face, or oregano and valor on feet, frankincense for my scar. And then I realized I was texting my friend Kelly.
Ah!
I was like, oh, sorry, I thought I was sending myself the message.
Whoops.
She's
no
frozen.
No water for you now. It's coming.
Oh,
you got food in your pajamas.
I can research some of that for you too.
And it said something about the lemon oil. The one drop in water helps.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't tried it. I was actually thinking I would try that.
I'd read grapefruit oil.
Water retention and appetite
suppression.
It didn't have grapefruit in there?
No, I had it, but it didn't.
It didn't help for weight loss? Yeah. There's different, I mean, you might say one thing on this book, and then that too. By the way, I have some of these books here, and if you want to buy them for $20, you don't have to, but I brought a few. I think they retail for like $25, and that's really cool. It has like all the singles and then all the blends. And it has like different massage techniques, teaching like the radio drop method. And then things for like oils for like mastitis, bursitis, lung cancer, congestive heart failure, all sorts of things. So, there's no app for this one.
It's not yet.
Not yet. So,
thank you so much
for
your time.
You.
I really appreciate it.
Yes,
thank
you
guys
so much. You need to eat some more food before you go.
Yes,
it does
look like
to dip.
That looks good. It looks really good.
And we gave up sugar for Lent, so we're not having the cookies.
Oh, that's too bad. That must have been really hard for you to make those cookies.
Actually, amazingly, because of the plexus, you know, I cook for our Bible study women, about 120 women every Wednesday.
Yes, she does.
And weeks. And I haven't had any of the stuff in weeks and weeks and weeks because
so
I've actually given up sugar foods before that.
Give you
and
hours.
I have the biggest
yes.
Of no clue. I mean, this is all sugar.
all of the requests I'm able to get in there and I bake and I